Good morning and welcome to the historic Basilica Cathedral of St. John the Baptist. We welcome all of you present and those joining us through live stream. We pray that you are in good health. We ask all present to please respect the instructions given by our parish ushers and the guidelines in place to prevent the spread of COVID-19, including using hand sanitizers, maintaining a social distance of 2 meters, and wearing face masks at all times within the church. At the time of Holy Communion, further instructions will be given, and at the end of Mass, we ask that you please follow the usher's instructions for exiting from the church. Our presider today is Father Cecil Critch. Our entrance chant is number 568 in our CBW, Praise to the Lord. Please stand.
Praise to the Lord, all of you, God's servants. Blessed be the name of the Lord, now and ever, from the rising up of the sun. May the Lord be praised, praise to the name of the Lord.
There is none like the Lord in the heavens or on earth, who lifts the weak out of dust, placing them with the mighty, who from the heaven's throne looks down so low. May the Lord be praised, praise to the name of the Lord.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
In the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, Father.
To prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries today, we ask the Lord to come into our hearts and heal us and strengthen us and to forgive us for the times we have failed to be merciful, we have failed to be compassionate to others. We ask the Lord's forgiveness.
You were sent to heal the contrite of heart.
Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison.
You came to call sinners.
Praise eleison, Christe eleison.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us.
Kyrie eleison.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sin, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Keep your family safe, O Lord, with unfailing care, that relying solely on the hope of heavenly grace, they may be defended always by your protection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the second letter of Paul to the Corinthians. It is necessary to boast, though nothing is to be gained by it. But I will go on to visions and revelations of the Lord. I know a person in Christ who 14 years ago was caught up in the third heaven, whether in the body or out of the body, I do not know. God knows. And I know that such a person, whether in the body or out of the body, I do not know, God knows, was caught up into paradise and heard things that are not to be told, that no mortal is permitted to repeat. On behalf of such a one, I will boast. But on my own behalf, I will not boast, except of my weaknesses. But if I wish to boast, I will not be a fool, for I will be spreading the truth. But I refrain from it, so that no one may think better of me than what is seen in me or heard from me, even considering the exceptional character of the revelations. Therefore, to keep me from being too elated, a thorn was given to me in the flesh, a messenger of Satan to torment me. To keep me from being too elated, three times I appealed to the Lord about this, that it would leave me. But he said to me, "My grace is sufficient for you, for power is made perfect in weakness." So I will boast all the more gladly of my weaknesses, so that the power of Christ may dwell in me. Therefore, I am content with the weaknesses, insults, hardships, persecutions, and calamities for the sake of Christ. For whenever I am weak, then I am strong. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our response to Psalm 34, "Taste and see that the Lord is good."
Taste and see that the Lord is good.
Taste and see that the Lord is good.
I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. My soul makes its boast in the Lord. Let the humble hear and be glad.
Taste and see that the Lord is good.
Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. I sought the Lord, and he answered me, and delivered me from all my fears.
Taste and see that the Lord is good.
Look to him and be radiant, so your faces shall never be ashamed. The poor one called and the Lord heard, and saved that person from every trouble.
Taste and see that the Lord is good.
The angel of the Lord encamps around those who fear him and delivers them. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the one who takes refuge in him.
Taste
taste and see that the Lord is good.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "No one can serve two masters, for a slave will either hate the one and love the other, or be devoted to the one and despise the other. You cannot serve God and wealth. And therefore I tell you, do not worry about your life, what you will eat or what you will drink, or about your body, what you will wear. Is not life more than food, and the body more than clothing? Look at the birds of the air. They neither sow nor reap nor gather into barns, and yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not of more value than they? And can any of you, by worrying, add a single hour to your span of life? And why do you worry about clothing? Consider the lilies of the field, how they grow. They neither toil nor spin. Yet I tell you, even Solomon in all his glory was not clothed like one of these. But if God so clothes the grass of the field, which is alive today and tomorrow is thrown into the oven, will he not much more clothe you, you of little faith? Therefore do not worry, saying, 'What we will eat, what will we eat, or what will we drink, or what will we wear?' For it is the Gentiles who strive for all these things. And indeed, your heavenly Father knows that you need all these things. But strive first for the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things will be given to you as well. So do not worry about tomorrow, for tomorrow will bring worries of its own. Today's troubles is enough for today." The Gospel of the Lord. In this morning's first reading from St. Paul to the Corinthians, he speaks of a thorn in the flesh that was given to him, which he considered to be a messenger of Satan. In other words, as far as he was concerned, it was detrimental to his spiritual well-being. Whatever Paul was referring to, and we don't know, he had an expectation that the Lord, through his prayer, would take it from him. Paul's prayer was answered, but not in the way that he expected. Not in the way that he wanted it to be answered. Paul was not delivered from this thorn in the flesh. Instead, the Lord assured him that in his weakness there is strength. The Lord's grace was enough and would see Paul through. Sometimes our greatest personal struggles can be the means through which we grow in our relationship with the Lord. And sometimes the struggles we experience help us to help others who struggle themselves, so that we are better able to accompany them through it. Our most painful experiences can open us up to a power that is greater than any merely human strength. And in the gospel today, we are given a lot of good advice. We reflect on what worries us the most. If it is money, then we have probably made it to God in our life. But we all worry from time to time, and worrying is part of our human condition. I'm sure that Jesus worried too. Parents worry about their children. Family members worry about each other. Young people worry about their future. You know, it's all part of the human condition. But Jesus calls us to live a more balanced life. The priority for us is for us to seek the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and not things of this world. Jesus makes reference in the gospel reading to the pagans, the Gentiles, who set their hearts only on material things. The gospel reading asks us today, what am I giving my heart to? What are my priorities in my life? And are they in line with God's priorities for me? Jesus declares, set your hearts on God's kingdom first and on his righteousness. Our primary preoccupation then is to be seeking and doing of God's will in our lives, and not to be so preoccupied with only the physical and material needs that we have. If that preoccupies our heart, then we have no room in our heart for God or for our neighbor. Jesus' priorities are seen in the Lord's Prayer, which we've been talking about all week pretty well. Hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. And he calls on us, his disciples, to make them our own priorities as well. He calls us to work for the coming of God's kingdom here and now, and for all God's people here and now. And our priority is that God, and the assurance that God has given us, that God is with us and always will look after us. Our prayers of intercession today. We pray for our Holy Father, Pope Francis, and our Bishop Peter, and all leaders, all those who lead and guide our church during these difficult times. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for a spirit of reconciliation and peace with our indigenous brothers and sisters in our country. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for our restructuring of our archdiocese. We pray for God's presence with us and God's Spirit to be with us in these decisions. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the sick recommended to our prayers, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all members of our families, especially for all families who are having difficult times when we have confrontations and disagreements and separations in our families, we pray for a spirit of healing and reconciliation in our families. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all those who have died, let's pray especially for Kevin and Patricia Marr. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For your own intentions today. We pray to the Lord. And God, our Heavenly Father, we thank you for all the graces and blessings you give us every day. And we make our prayer in the name of Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, but through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, to humble himself, to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, but through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Wash away our iniquity, O Lord, cleanse us of our sin. Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Let us pray. O Lord our God, who once established these created things to sustain us in our frailty, grant, we pray, that they may become for us now the sacrament of eternal life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary, fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest a resurrection. And so with all the angels and saints, we declare your glory as with one voice we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
And therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Peter our Bishop, the clergy, and all your people. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, St. John the Baptist, St. Peter, and St. Paul, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, I said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
We share the peace of Christ now with one another.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. An act of spiritual communion, a prayer for those who are unable to receive Holy Communion at this time. My Jesus, I believe you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you, for you are already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. To ensure that the reception of Holy Communion takes place in a safe and respectful manner, we ask that you please follow these instructions. Instead of individually replying Amen upon receiving the host, there will be one general attestation of Amen before distribution begins. Please remain standing in your pew until invited forward by an usher. Ensure your face mask is correctly worn before coming forward, and maintain a 2-meter social distance in the communion line. As you approach the front of the line, sanitize your hands before receiving communion. Bow towards the host. In silence, receive the host in your hands. Step aside to consume the host. Return to your pew as directed by ushers. Those unable to receive Holy Communion in the hand may come forward to receive a blessing.
The body of Christ.
Amen. Our communion chant, Let Us Be Bread, 6.4, in Celebrate in Song.
before the world, let us be wine, love freely poured. Let us be one in the Lord. I am the bread of life, broken for all. Eat now and hunger no more. Let us be bread, blessed by the Lord, broken and shared, life for the world. Let us be wine, love freely poured. Let us be one in the Lord. You are my friends if you keep my commands, no longer servants, but friends. Let us be bread, blessed by the Lord, broken and shared, life for the world. Let us be wine, love freely poured. Let us be one in the Lord. See how my people have nothing to eat. Give them the bread that is you. Let us be bread, blessed by the Lord, broken and shared, life for the world. Let us be wine, love freely poured. Let us be one in the
Let us pray. O God, who have willed that we be partakers in the one bread and the one chalice, grant us, we pray, so to live that made one in Christ, we may joyfully bear fruit for the salvation of the world through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I don't know if you looked around the church, in the back here we have a new shrine to Our Lady of Perpetual Help, something that's very dear to my heart. So was donated to the church, so it's in the back, a little shrine to Our Lady of Perpetual Help. So on this day of Mary, it would be a nice idea for to visit that and to say a prayer, especially for our archdiocese and for our help during this pandemic as well. So I would be very grateful to the Marr family, Kevin and Patricia Marr, as part of their estate to leave that shrine of Our Lady. We pray to Mary for help and protection during the pandemic. O Mary, you always shine in our path as a sign of salvation and of hope. We entrust ourselves to you, health of the sick, who at the cross took part in Jesus' pain, keeping your faith firm. You, salvation of your people, know what we need, and we are sure you will provide so that as in Cana of Galilee, we may return to joy and to feasting after this time of trial. Help us, Mother of Divine Love, to conform to the will of the Father and to do as we are told by Jesus, who has taken upon himself our sufferings and carried our sorrows to lead us through the cross to the joy of the resurrection. Amen. Under your protection we seek refuge, Holy Mother of God. Do not disdain the entreaties of we who are in trial, but deliver us from every danger, O glorious and blessed Virgin. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless all of us in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace, glorifying the Lord by our lives.
Thanks be to God. Our missioning chant, This Day God Gives Me, number 650 in our CBW.
This day God gives me strength of high heaven, sun and moon shining, flame in my hearth, flashing of lightning, wind in its swiftness, deeps of the of earth. This day God sends me strength to sustain me, might to uphold me, wisdom as guide. Your eyes are watchful, your ears are listening, your lips are